jungle.
Hello friends, good evening to one and all. Now I am going to show you the important topics of Ptsp, that is probability theory and stochastic processes, Ptsp. In this Ptsp, now I am going to discuss about the few topics about joint probability, and another one is conditional probability. These two are the most important for JNTU examination and as well as mid also. So please try to concentrate on these topics. Now I am going to discuss the joint probability. First of all, in this joint probability, we have probability of A intersection B is called joint probability when the two events A and B are which intercepts at a sample space. That yes. So probability of A intersection B is called joint probability. Understood friends? Just note it down. The probability of A intersection B is called joint probability. In sample space, yes. See, I will show you the equation. The probability of A intersection B is equals to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A union B. This is equation 1, take it as. And the second equation, probability of A union B equals to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. This is take it as equation 2. So just understand that here intersection is come, then we have to take it here as a union. If we have to take union here, then we have to keep here intersection. These two are the differences. From equation 2, see here, A intersection B is mutually exclusive events. Then we have to take it as A intersection B is equals to phi. Then we have, if we apply probability on both sides, then probability of A intersection B, this becomes as 0. So take it as equation 3. So substitute equation 3 in 2, then what we get? P of here, P of A union B equals to P of A plus P of B. So this value becomes 0 here, so minus 0. The whole understand is P of A union B equals to P of A plus P of B. This is the equation. If A and B are independent events, independent means what we get? We have to take it as independent events means if A and B are independent events, then P of A by B, we get P of A. Here numerator we have A, so that's why we have to take it as P of A. If P of B by A means, we have to take it as P of B for independent events. Otherwise P of A intersection B means P of A into P of B. So up to here the joint probability is completed. So let us see the diagram, Venn diagram. This is A and this is B. This is the intersection, A intersection B. Here yes, this is a sample space. Up to here the joint probability is completed. Now I am going to discuss about the conditional probability. See, in this conditional probability I will going to show you the definition. See here, the two, if the measure of probability of event A, that means the measure of probability of event A is equals to the measure of probability of event B, see here, this is the events. The measure of probability of event A is equal to the measure of probability of event B, which is non-probability event. This is non-probability event, non-probability to zero. Understood? The measure of probability of event A is equal to the measure of probability of event B. This is the definition. And now I am going to show you the formula. P of A by B equals to, see here, P of A by B for conditional probability, we get probability of A intersection B by probability of B. See here, in this conditional, what is in the denominator, we get here P of B, where P of B not equal to 0, what I said in equation. P of A by B equals to P of A intersection B by P of B. And then P of B by A means likewise P of A intersection B by, in denominator we have A, so that's why P of A, where P of A not equal to 0. And then for independent events, from here, from this, here independent events we have P of A by B is P of A, and P of B by A we have P of B. So take here, for independent events, independent events, we have P of A by B equals to P of A, and P of B by A we have P of B. So equate for these equations. From take it as 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. Equate 1 and 3 and 2 and 4. 1 and 3, 2 and 4. See, if we equate 1 and 3, we have P of A equals to here P of A intersection B by P of B. From that, P of A intersection B equals to P of A into P of B. From 2 and 4, we get P of B by A means, for independent events, we get P of B. P of B is equals to P of A intersection B by P of A. We get P of A intersection B. P of A intersection B is equals to P of B into P of A. So these two equations are equal. That's why this is the conditional probability. So if we take mutually exclusive, that means probability of A intersection B is equals to 0, then if we substitute here, probability of A into probability of B is equals to 0, we get probability of A is equals to 0 and probability of B is also 0. So note it down, this is the final answer. Here the conditional probability can be defined for quantity only, but not for other three axioms we have. Up to here is enough for you. It only satisfies for quantity. Yes. Do you have any doubts, means you can keep me a comment, and as well as if you like this video, means just like it, and if you subscribe for this channel, you will get more updates of my videos. Thanking you for watching this video. Thanks, friends.